Hey guys, it's the Sketch Monkey here, and welcome back to the channel. Now, just like I did with the Jeep Wagoneer concept video, the previous video, and this video today, I don't usually cover either concept cars or one-off cars, such as this Aston Martin right here. The reason being, because it's very uncommon that we're going to see the one-off cars, and the concept cars are usually not the final product that we're going to see out on the road. But I decided to make an exception here today, and I'm really glad I did. I got so many questions about this car and emails and DMs, so of course I want to make a video on it, because this to me is the most special Aston Martin since 1999. And in this video, I'm going to tell you exactly why. But first off, let's start with talking about the Aston Martin design language in general. What is an Aston Martin? The thing that comes up when I think about an Aston Martin is elegance. And more than elegance, when it comes to design of the cars, is proportions. So if I were to sketch any type of, if I had a standard two-seater front engine V12 GT cruiser car, the car that I would sketch would inevitably be an Aston Martin shape, because the proportions is something that Aston Martin has perfected over the years. But this wasn't always the case, and later in this video I'm going to show you the comparison between some older models and what exactly was implemented from those models into this one-off spectacular Aston Martin. So this time the Aston Martin Q division has come up with something a little bit different from creating another 007 car. This time, they've created something truly amazing. It was made for a private client who wants to stay anonymous, and good luck with that, driving around in this car. And this specific client wanted something more special than any regular Aston Martin that is on the market today. A very unusual one-off. And the result is, of course, the Aston Martin Victor. The Bespoke team crafted this unique coupe by combining styling elements from the 1970s, and this is exactly what I want to show you and have some fun with. That's when it's going to get interesting later on in this video. From the 70s and the 80s, and combined it with modern technology. This is usually a winning concept in my book, and this time, of course, it's no different. It all started with the V12 engine from the 177. However, the Victor here gets a more powerful tune. 836 horsepower and 606 pound-feet of torque to be exact. And guess what? It's mated to a proper 6-speed manual gearbox. And this means that this is the most powerful manual ever made by Aston Martin. The price has not been revealed for the Victor, which is pretty normal when we talk about one-offs just like this one. And I mean, if you have to ask. But now let's talk about the design. We're gonna jump into Photoshop. I wanna show you exactly what is going on here and why I love this shape so much. So let's jump into Photoshop and let me show you exactly what I mean. So remember that I said in the beginning that this is my favorite Aston Martin since 1999. And the reason for that is because 1999 was the year when Aston Martin showed us the exceptionally cool V8 Vantage Le Mans. And here it is. What's so cool about this car to me? And when I was a kid, this would just blew my mind, because I was used to the DB7 shape. And you can see that you have some DB7 lines right here in the greenhouse, this specific area right here, or the greenhouse in general over the entire field here is a lot of DB7. But then here in the front, you can see that we have some muscle car feeling to this front end. So the mixture between having the elegant shapes of, you know, a shark shape of the DB7 in combination with this type of muscle car front end was just something that I haven't seen before. And on top of that, it's more of a subtle muscle car. It's more of an elegant muscle car design with the soft curvatures all over, very typical for the melted cheese 90s era, but in this case it actually works. And a detail that I love, when I was a kid I remembered all the way, you know, it stuck with me all through all these years, is this intake in the front, and also the dark tinted windows, and of course this hood scoop in the middle, right there, right center in the hood. So this was my favorite Aston Martin for a very long time. It's one of the coolest looking Aston Martins ever produced. But now let's have a look at the Victor here, and let's compare the rear, for example. So the rear here, and I'm gonna tell you exactly why I'm choosing the V8 Volante at the bottom here and not the V8 Vantage. The Volante is the open top in Aston Martin language. The Vantage is the original coupe. So if we have a look at the modernization and how beautifully done this is, you can see that we have a very, very big ducktail right here that is all completely integrated in the shape of the car. And look at how beautifully sculpted or modernized this is in this new shape here. We have the exact same curvatures in this area that we have right here, but of course in a modern way. And on top of that, we have the Valkyrie head rear lights. They kind of symbolize the old ones as well, because they are in a way rectangular in their shape as well. Even though they're separate by small LEDs, the overall shape still resembles the original one down here. And then of course we have the massive side skirt right here, and this is also visualized here in the original one from 77. I think this is 77 model. So there is a lot going on here that is, in my opinion, a very beautiful transition from the super cool V8 Volante from the late 70s to the new Aston Martin Victor. And it's something that is not at all easy to do. What I love about the Victor here is that it is a new take on the Le Mans from 1999. Because we have the same kind of principle, the same kind of philosophy behind it. We have a DB7, smooth, the traditional GT lines, GT cruiser lines of Aston Martin, in combination with something completely different. And in this case, the almost muscle car looking front end, which is a lot vertical than we're used to seeing when we have the lights, you know, as usual on an Aston Martin, something like this. We have the lights in here and then the same on this part right there. So this is a mix of two different design philosophies, but it still works. And I think the new Victor here is the exact same thing, the same philosophy, but of course 20 years later. Now let's have a look at the front view here, and then I'm gonna talk to you why I chose the Volante over the Vantage later on in this video as well. What I love about the front end here is we have the round headlights. So we don't have the headlights sitting up here as we would kind of expect. You can see that it kind of suits the car. If we were to put the headlights on the car right as we have it right there, I could render these headlights in and remove these and just have it be more of a traditional looking modern Aston Martin. But that would completely ruin my fascination with this car, because I think they managed to make this upright front end here integrate so well with the modern looking greenhouse, just like we had in the Le Mans. You have a very sleek looking greenhouse in combination with a completely different style in the front. And as I said, this is not something that is easily done beautifully, but it's super well executed in this Victor here. So I want to talk to you why I chose the open top here and then not the coupe. The reason is, if you have a look at this Volante down here, I think they based it more on the Volante than the Vantage, simply because you can see more elements from the Volante being featured in the Victor. So let's have a look at the regular Volante here. You can see it's missing the side skirt right there, and it's missing a lot of details in the front. But it's even more noticeable if you look at the rear. You can see that this ducktail here, or spoiler integrated that we have right here, it's nowhere near as big as it is on the open top. You can see this is a lot higher here, and this works a lot better in the Victor as well. And this piece right here, I think this curvature right here is my favorite design of any of the lines of the Victor. This is my favorite area when it comes to the design of this car. So looking at the regular Vantage here, it becomes a little more tamer. It's a lot more subtle than it is when you compare it to the open top. And I think This is an exaggeration of the Vantage, the Volante here. You have the bigger ducktail and you have the side skirts as well. This part down here, this is not really modernized here, but it is a lot more aggressive than you have on the regular Vantage here. So, is there anything I would change on the Victor? Well, there is one thing I would like to experiment with. And that is this Victor now, it has the very modern Vantage line, shoulder line, which is this line right here. It is extremely straight. It goes from the front and then just almost straight to the back right here. So what I would like to just check out here and just play around with is, what if we use the line from 2015? Specifically in this area, the rear shoulder line, which goes something like this. It has a bit, just a tiny bit of curvature to it. So what I want to do is just to try and see what that will look like, because this is the brand new Vantage line that we have here. It kind of almost dips here in the back. You can see here, it doesn't go up again. But what I want to do is just try and see if we can get this up and see what that will look like. So here we go. What I'm gonna do is just very, very subtle change to this car and just add some curvature to this rear shoulder. I think it would add some beefiness to this car. And in fact, the original V8 Volante from the late 70s, it did have a bit of a curvature to this part right here. So let's see how this is going to look. I don't think you're gonna see any big difference just looking at it like this right now. But when I switch back and forth between the before and after, that's where you're going to see the change that we've done. I think that's it. We don't need more than that. We have a bit, you see a subtle little bump there. I think that is going to make a bit of a difference here. So let's see. This is before. Let's zoom in here. Before and after. So before and after. I mean, I like them both. One line is 5 years old, and the other line that they actually went with in this design is from today. So it really doesn't matter. It looks good either way. It was just a fun experiment to check out. But I kind of do like the little bump more because it gives more definition to the rear. And as always, when you have a rear powered car, I want it to be visualized in the shape as well, that you have the power coming from the back and that the back is planted with some beefy shoulders in the back, way beefier than in the front. But of course, that's just my opinion, some fun experiment. So, for everyone asking what I think about the Aston Martin Victor, I don't know how long this video is going to be, but that is my answer. Whether it's short or not, I don't know. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Take care.